Hello YouTube, this is Bogra and we are back in the base. Now I lost an episode between the last one I recorded put up and the one before that to where we actually created these. Unfortunately the audio somehow got corrupted, but them are ME drives and you create them simply using this. So that's where your engineering processors come from. And then the other, if you look inside, you got these slots and you basically got storage cells. Oh, you got different kinds of storage cells. Let me spell it right. And they range from the 1 all the way up to, I think, 64. Yeah, 64. As you see, the number of types stays the same. What changes is the number of items. So in the beginning, you're not really going to have a large amount of a lot of items. You're mostly going to have a lot of a few items. And so the 4K end up being the best. These 64K are kind of later on when you just start running massive amounts of queries, shit like that. We're probably never going to really use them. We'll just keep adding these guys. I mean, the only time we'd actually use them is if we filled this up. And they're pretty simple to create. So if you look at the 4K, you got to have this guy. Iron, quartz glass. Quartz glass is easily glass with the nether quartz or the quartz itself. This one, there it is. These guys are created from three of these, which are created from those. Now once you get up, it basically gets, so if we look at the 1-4, we just use a simple one for the 1K. 4, we combine three of those. 16, we're combining three of the ones from before. And for 64, we're combining three of those. So you see how it gets really expensive really quickly. That's why we use the other types. Alright, so today we are gonna do bees, guys. Bees. Bees, bees. Bees, bees. Now we got a good many bees here. I clicked some off camera. We got some frames and apiaries. Now we need more apiaries. Simply put, we need apiaries, guys. Apiaries. Alright, so if you look up apiary, there's simply some wood and some impregnated cases, which takes these. That's what apiaries take. So, as you see, we're not going to be able to create more until we get our carpenter stuff set up, and that's how you create that. So, pretty much, you can't just go straight to using bees. You had to have the other stuff. And this is a carpenter. Now, pretty simple. It just takes a lot of bronze. So, we want two of these guys. Create them. Once again, more bronze. So we keep them. The second thing we want is a squeezer, because this is what's going to help us get our seed oil. So once again, we need a sturdy case, and we're going to make two of those. We are going to need another one later on. Not right now. Now, this difference for this one is it takes 10. All right, so. Now, oh wait, no DNA. Not there. Where's it at? There's something super I'm trying to find, guys. Trying to remember where it's at. Oh god, my wife warned me that I did that. Okay, I'll worry about that. It's like, we need a bee analyzer though. So if we look, we got two type of analyzer. We got the B one here. Now, as you see, once again, we have to have a carpenter to do that. So from this point on, pretty much everything will take a carpenter. So we are going to grab a couple basic things we're going to need over there. One being glass panes. And we'll get a stack of these. That should be enough. In addition to that, see, I made a lot of bronze, and it was primarily for this. We're going to get a lot of this stuff. Pretty much going to, no, we'll leave 4 stacks here for other stuff. But that right there should, oh my god, it's the blood moon. Alright, I am going to cheat, guys, and set it to dawn, because the blood moon just totally freezes up my computer with the amount of mobs. So we're just going to let these guys burn. Luckily, y'all can't get me. Oh, I did manage to get Enderman head earlier. Yeah, for Enderman head. All right, let's see. We don't have this area lit up. We don't have. All right, so we're going to set now some of this stuff. So if we look in my bag of goodies, we got a couple of tesseracts. Yeah. So, fuck. All right. I totally forgot a couple of things from the house, guys. Or actually, not the house, from the massive fuck you landscape thing. Oh shoot. Come here! Oh, that's one other thing I almost forgot to show you guys that I'm very excited about. Now, I don't know how many of you have noticed that my weapons look a lot different. That's because they're made out of pure enderum. Yeah, that's right. I went and collected some, a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff, oh god. A lot of redstone with my pickaxe. Basically, the quarries I've got done running. And if you look, like, let's say diamond, 225 emerald, 820. Let's look at iron. 13,000, guys. Lapis, 44. Redstone, 25. So we've got enough stuff to last for a ton of time. A ton. So we don't have to worry about running out anytime soon. So we are going to pick this little guy up. Alright, we don't need you right there. What we need is you guy right there. Alright, so we basically want to... Hello, Mission Man. The other thing I set up, sir, guys, is these, biofuel. And I'll show you the farm outside, but basically it produces seeds and wheat. All the wheat comes through here, gets processed in here. Showed it off to here. This trash can is there. It gets its priority too, so that when this fills up with wheat, the farm won't stop. This is at very bad redstone signal, just extended the one we had over here, and all the power goes into here, and we got these little guys here, the enhanced ones, because they'll do better, and that's just to help to shore up our power. God damn it, I keep doing that. And we've got a little Enderman here. Come on, you give me your that's two in a row I've killed, and two heads I've got. Ah, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Alrighty, so we want to do with this guy is stick him. What do you want? For right now, we're just going to stick him right here. And we're going to create a new... Hold on 1 second, guys. It crashed. I'll be back in a minute. Alright, we are back. So, this shot is going to be called base power, and that's going to be, I think, 102 is what we need. Yeah, let's re-put it in there. Base power, and this is basically a test right that all of our power is going to come through, so we need 102. Check it. Wait, 102 is query power. Yeah, 103. We're going to add this down here. Wait. Well, either way, I think I got some of these messed up. Either way, we got a base power. Alright, let's configure this guy to send energy. There we go. Now we got power for our base. Alrighty, let's hope there's nothing nasty outside our doorway. Unfortunately, I can't get in my door. I put concrete down here. I can't get indoors. Apparently, concrete blocks won't let you in or something for some reason. And this is our bee production facility. I do think it looks pretty cool. We got a big stairway just because there's room for it. Made out of all natural woods. Yeah, natural woods, guys. With no torches outside because I like to live dangerously. Alright, so what we're basically going to have is... How are we going to do this? Alright, this little guy is just going to be right here. We're going to set him to that. He is receiving power. Alrighty, so... Now, basically, let me show you what's down here. We I never put the ladders in. We don't know. Alright, so this is where all of our BDNA is going to eventually be held. We've got ones over here for the outputs, ones over there for the inputs. And basically our machines that input anything in there are going to be over here, and the ones that actually need something from are going to be over there. So the carpenters are going to be over here. I have this one there. Gonna have this one here. Yeah. Did I make squeezers? There they are. So actually I wanna do that differently. Oh no, that'll do. So our squeezer is gonna be over here. We are gonna put one over here, and what we should be able to do, and then if we just take some of these guys and we can take and say bam, and they'll go over there. Eventually we will put another carpenter over there, but not for right now. Alright, so to point a crane, this squeezer. Alright, I forgot something else, guys. Yeah. The other thing I forgot were the reservoirs. And create some water. So, I'll be back in a second. I'm gonna go grab this stuff and I'll be back. So while I'm down here, guys, there are a couple other changes I made. You see this is a resonant. And if you look in the augmentation, it has the full augmentation. Oh my god, this thing will work so freaking fast. Like, I made this all in the span of a couple minutes. I also did it with the induction furnace. And then also, I made one octet capacitor and put in here. Yeah. So it goes a lot faster now. I just put like three stacks of quartz in there. It's already went through like 1.5. That is ridiculous. Yeah. So these are pretty simple. And we've got what we need. Okay, I'm probably forgetting something else that I'll figure out once I get over there. But we'll figure that out when we can. So also you'll notice I got my cocoa bean thing there. It works out really handy because I can come through and I can basically hit these on the end and it takes out like all of these. So yeah, we'll get to why we need to use cocoa beans in a minute. Alright, so I have my reservoir and we're gonna put it actually right here. And we'll put that in. And then we'll put this little guy in and extract always. Alright, so he needs it. So if we look up apiary. Oh yeah, I want to put this little guy down too. Let's put him down right quick. For right now, we'll just put him right there. Alrighty, so if we look at apiary. It's going to take seed oil. Which ones are just looking at? Oh, yeah, bee analyzer. All right, so let's go over here. So if you look at analyzer. No, it's bee analyzer. That's right, it's like really freaking weird. We need diamonds and redstone, which I don't believe I grabbed. No, I didn't. Oh, I'll be back again. All right, we're back, guys. So, let's look up our B-Elizer. We actually want to create a B-Elizer and a Tree-Elizer right quick. No, not him. Him. So, we got 10 on the outside. And we're going to have diamonds here. And we're going to have this here. This here. Have this and this here. Fuck. Oh, sorry for the language if you're offended. But I put in the wrong one. Go away. So, what we want is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the reason I'm only putting 4 down there is because this would create as many as it can. So, if I just leave this in here, it'll basically create all of them. And we don't want that. So as you see, if I pull this out, it pops it up there. I put that, it shows it. So, So, that's working. The next thing we need to do is run our power cables, because all of these machines take power. So we are going to use the good cables. And this is just because I don't want to end up having to run from multiple places. So we're basically just going to run from one place. So as soon as we put power in here, what we see is this starts to raise. And if we give it just a minute, then it should pop over here. Yes. And the resources were used. Now I want to go ahead and create the trealizer next. We're not going to use it, but we are going to create. Now this is going to let us scan our bees. However, right now we currently can't do anything. Why? Because, actually let me just pop that back in there. If we look at it, we had to have honey here. And we get honey from various things. So what we're going to take is a regular honeycomb. Going to take our squeezer, which is right here, this one right here, and we're going to plop it in there. No, we forgot to create one other thing. Yeah, we forgot one other thing. So we actually need, okay, I'll be back with the carpenter. Well, wait, we need a, I want to show you guys how to create this first. So you're going to get, I got to put a landing here because currently getting through this door is a bit of, that time it went quicker, but I've been there for like 20 seconds just trying to get through the freaking door. Alright, so if you look at the machines, which should be, where you at machines? Where is the machines at? Anybody know? If you know, let me know. Where did they go? Oh, there they are. Alright, so we got a couple of different ones. Centrifuge. This is the little guy we need. So drop him in there. Alright, so we need this guy. Alright, so yeah. We should just need him. Alright, so what he's going to allow us to do is to take these honeycombs that we've got. And I may end up reorganizing how some of this stuff in here looks later on. But if that's the case, it'll be later on. So, I'm going to plop him right here. Do we got more power cables? Did I put them up? Yeah, I did. Alright, so we just need one more. And then when we put these guys in here, he is going to break them down. What we actually do is we'll go ahead and get all of this and put in there. And kind of letting break it all down. Well, we can't put it all in there at once. Shit. That's where we're going to set up our buffer chest. But not completely worried about that right now. Alright, so we get these two things. Wax and honey. And we can break the honey down. And that's for later on using stuff. But if we put it here, then we, for example... Let's take, oh, actually, one second. Let me get this chest. Basically, right now, I'm going to temporarily hold stuff in this chest. So we're going to throw this, and this chest. All right, so if I grab a P, which ones are we going to use? Let's use the old guy. So we got a B. We don't know anything about him, but if we put him in here, now we can see lifespan. It's how long he's going to live. Production speed, slowest. Pollination speed, what he needs around him. How fodder he'll create 2 weeks' time. How big his territory is. And what kind of effects he has, which is none. So, we can see a whole bunch of good stuff about this. And this comes into play later on. However, we do need some more stuff. Alright, so we want to take this guy... This guy. Yeah, that's all we want now. So, what we basically have, we have an ender query set out back. And how are we going to do these? Trying to show how I wanna do this. Because Ashley wanna do opposite. So we're gonna take out, which one do we wanna take out, guys? This carpenter, this squeezer are gonna be taken out. Alright. Run this a little differently than I originally thought. Alright, so we're gonna have, let's put all of this down here. Have inner core here. And this is basically to the farm we have outside that's running our stuff. Alright, so blue, black, black is kinda gonna be the base wide transportation system. And I think my system's going to crash fucking in. Alright, when it comes back up, I'll be back, guys. Alright, so we're back. Didn't crash, it just had a special moment. So, blue, black, black is basically gonna be a base-wide system. And it's basically gonna be a filtered system. In other words, like anything that comes to the system has to be filtered when it comes out. Because if not, we'll end up getting a whole bunch of stuff we don't want here and there. Or, if we just set up a chest and we have it going in and we don't have filter set on the other side, what's gonna happen is it's going to get clogged up, and everything that's depending on going through that system is going to be messed up. So I do have filters with me right here. Yeah, I have them on me. So insert, filter it. Now I already got a whole bunch of seeds from before. From the farm over there, I kind of got a stock of them up, so we didn't have to wait forever. Alrighty, so we should be able to set this to always extract, and we should get all of our seeds in there. So let's go ahead and put all of these seeds in there. Alright, next thing we want to do is set up another one and have our squeeze out. And then we should be able to just, oh god, I hate when it does that. There we go, put this right beside it. Oh, we got them right here. Set this up. Alrighty, have this always extracting. Is this an insert? What you're gonna see is that everything's gonna start going in there. The only thing we have to do is hook up some power to it. So once again, we're gonna run it off up here. And there we go. And we're getting seed oil in. Now this thing is not the fastest in the world, so you may have to wait a bit of time to put seed oil in here. However, oh, so if we see, actually, let me get my workbench backpack out. I know we're gonna need some of these. Alright, I don't want to do all of those, but let's do, let's get a little over a stack's worth. Alright, so I want to create apiaries. This thing works pretty simply. So we gotta have impregnated casing first, right? If we looked, we have that. So we need an impregnated casing first, which basically means we need our logs, which I just so happen to have with me. And all we have to do for this is boom, 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 and put them there. And then what it will do is automatically crane it as it gets enough seed oil. Now, I don't want quite 64 of them, but or three stacks, but I do want a couple. So one, Actually, all we want is two of them, so it's eight. Like I said, guys, as you see, really, really freaking slow. And there's no way to speed these machines up, unfortunately. So you want to create stuff before you're going to need it. Start sending some stuff up, and we're going to set these guys up. And it's... I don't want her causing me wither effects. Oh, I think she was a good kind of witch. I don't know. No, there are no good kinds of witches. What am I saying? But, yeah. So, this is going to kind of be our bee producing area. So, we want this guy here. This one here. This one here. Alright, so we want five per. We want two lines for bees. That should give us enough room for what I want to do. Alrighty. So, if we go in and get one of our bees now, on this nice rainy day. Alright, so if we look at a bee, for example, let's look at our meadows. Oh, that's what R does. Let me use you. If we do U, we keep going. No, not R. We hit R, we go over. Why isn't it doing it? Okay, it's not showing me the right things, guys. There it is. We see bee producing, and we see what we can get. So, the first thing we want to do is get where we can make ivory. But to do that, we need two things. Word jelly and pollen. So, forest and meadows makes a common. Hit U on that little guy and go back to three spaces. We get to cultivate it, which is the next one we want. Hit U, go back through spaces. We get the noble or majestic, and we need both of those, actually. We need a noble, and then we use that noble to make a majestic. And then we get the imperial, which would give us the warrior jelly. So if we click on this guy... Oh, wrong thing. With the U bun... Oh, it won't show us there what we get. Warrior J, that's what we want. We also need pollen. And to get that, 2, 3, 4, we need these still. We need to cultivate it. But then if we go one over here, we see diligent and unwary. And that diligent will go into an industrious, which then... I cannot click the right thing to save my life. Will give us this pollen cluster, and we need that. Then what are the two things we need? Now, we want to do... So, let's go outside. That way I can show you guys something else. And I know I grabbed the other bee. There's a reason for that. So if we click here, and what we'll see is temperature is normal. So we got normal temperature, but we got no queen. So, if we take and we scan this little guy, what we'll get here, when we do here, is what he needs. So, he needs a normal, which means we can use him to breed all of the bees we want. Now, the reason I'm going to use him, let me click off of that. The reason we're going to use him is because we got a shit ton of them. Yeah, we've got a lot of them. Now, if we click on the use... We can still get the common out of him, okay? So we can still get our common, and we can get a whole bunch of other stuff too, and we can get commons from a whole bunch of other stuff. So we could use Tropor, Marsh, if Modest Wintery. However, it's going to be Forest and Meadows that we use. Excuse me. Because, let me drop this stuff back in our system. It's going to be the meadows and commons we use, or meadows and forests, and the reason for this is that we got more of them than anything else. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we're going to do 10 of these little guys. Now I'm going to place them in there because we don't have enough room, like, not to. Now, there are no ways to really automate getting better bees. Unless you're willing to have this large overflow and do a complete like luck based system. I mean, I could just start shoving bees in these and be like, okay, whatever happens, happens. But there's no guarantee what I'm gonna get, and I'm gonna most likely, especially if I leave on overnight, gets this overflood of bees. Alright, so next we want to see exactly how many of everything we have. So now we have three queen of the meadows. We don't really need to have to worry about keeping meadows drones. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Boom, 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 boom. I think that's all the meadow drones we have. It is 6, 7. Actually, we can't use that little guy because we actually have none of these drones with us. Oh, this is gonna be a pain in the ass. Can we use a steadfast drone? So let's see what we can use this guy for. Yeah. We can't use him. We did the unusual, so we can't really use him. So you see, it kind of can get to be a pain in the ass. So right now, we're actually not going to be able to get all of those bees to start breeding. So we don't have enough drones. Jerome doesn't have enough drones. But that's fine, because we'll get these started. And then from there, we'll get more. We may have to actually create a couple more apiaries to breed some of the other guys in. So as you see, that bar filling up, that's because it's creating a queen. What's basically going to happen is this little guy will eventually die off. So if we look, alright, so we actually have no flowers over there. So we're going to get us a couple of flowers. And when using flowers, you need to use regular Minecraft flowers. Now, I'm not going to get a whole lot over there right now because, oh my god, when these guys start producing, they will just inhabit that entire freaking thing with flowers. If you really don't want the flowers all over the place, you may want to create it with like semen around it, and then place the flowers in the select places, and that should keep them from creating a whole lot. There. These parts are not going to produce in the rain either. No. So you see, not daytime, rain. That's the other thing. Yeah, you got different attributes for your bees. And some will be nocturnal, some will be daytime. The whole ultimate goal is to either create a bee that is can operate in any conditions. Which means it can operate in rain, it can operate underground, it can operate day, nighttime, all of this stuff, or to create the average that we're going to create, because with them are a multi-block structure, and with them we can put stuff like rain shields on it, we can put lighting on frames on it, you can put different types of frames, and those different types of frames will basically let you know if will let you alter the abilities. You can put ones that can, you can alter temperature, humidity, all of this stuff. So as we see now, we got all the things we need. There's no red X's. And what's basically going to happen is these guys are going to produce until they die off. And there's a nice little creeper. So we're going to leave them there. There are some other stuff we want. And I am hoping we have that mod installed. I believe we do, because if not, it's a massive pain in the ass. I believe we do, because I believe I checked this and tested it. Let's get that out of there. So, let's just do a search for DNA, and yeah, DNA extractor is what we want. Now this little guy is going to let us extract the DNA out of our little guys. So luckily, oh, I hit the wrong thing. Luckily, I believe we have all of this. I think this is the right thing. I am hoping it is. Well, we're going to see. We need a couple of pistons. Oh shit, I keep forgetting that. I don't know if it's just this version, but you get this one up here that has the archaeology plank and then this regular one. Oh, we have no planks. One second. I actually ran out of planks in the system, guys. So, let's get ourselves 64 more. Let's do a DNA thing. So we just need two of these. But the good thing is, even if this isn't the right thing and we wasted time, then guess what? I have so many resources. It doesn't really matter. I already think I have a hopper in there. I do. Oh no, we don't want that one. Yeah, there we go. That's more. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, what am I missing? Oh, I never created it. Derpy derpy. Oh god, you mean I had to create 4 more? God. This is why with the crafting benches I just set all of this stuff up ahead of time. Because I didn't want you guys to have to sit through that. Because that does get painful. Alrighty, now we got our DNA machine. Now the main purpose of all these DNA machines is using the forestry. Now you see all of this stuff around here? That's because they can pollinate. And we're actually going to set that up too, just because it'll help us. So, actually, no, we're not going to set it up there. So this other guy be set up right over here. Yeah. I'm going to knock this block out because eventually we're going to connect a pipe there. So if we connect this little guy and look. So what we'll have is that these will go here. And then all their lovely goody DNA will be extracted. And that's all we need to do. Let's hope that can plug into it. It can. Once again, set that to extract. So one of the reasons that actually we're gonna have it run down the side of the tank, so that it doesn't block off anything. But you see, perfect. I totally had that planned out. Yeah, totally had that planned out. All right, so we're just gonna take a be here for test purposes, and we'll just take these two guys. So if we place this in here, and it's not working. Why isn't it working? Alright, 1 second, guys. Let me see why this isn't working. Because I thought that's how it went. Okay, guys, I figured out why it's not working. And the reason is we had to have these lab wares. So we're going to go and create 64 of them. And it's just the planes and the diamond in the bottom. It'll consume one of these for every 10 bees. So what you're going to see is once this bee goes down and gets extracted, then that one is. So if we look down here, bam, there we go. Is we have some liquid DNA. 200 megabytes. Now, we can use that for various other things. One thing being is we can basically insert traits into our bees. So, once we get a final bee we want, we can take that bee, those bees, and we can give them the longest lifespan, the highest productivity, all of this stuff. And that will allow us to create, basically, super bees. The next thing we want to do is I didn't get everything I needed while I go. Alright, so. So that's working. The next thing we can do is we can start to mutate trees. And all I need to do is get saplings. Now, when doing the tree mutations, first I'll keep in mind the only trees that are going to work is, told you guys sometimes I have a hard time getting in this door, is vanilla Minecraft trees or forestry trees. So for example, if we look in here, I believe it was in here I had it. No, it's in the other one. Alright, so we get... We're gonna get some birch. Actually, let's just do sapling source. Alright, so we got a birch sapling. We're gonna get like 16 of those. Dark oak sapling. We're gonna get like 16 of those. See how some of them in Tura Mine Factory Reloaded? Those are not gonna work for us. We want those. And them are the ones we want. And we got some jungle. I'm gonna have to create some kind of ledge there to help me get in that door. And then we'll see if we gain. First, we don't have the chocolate frames, which makes this whole process take a hell of a lot longer. Ooh, but we about have a dead bee. We about have a dead bee. Alright, that's good. So, while we're waiting for them bees to die, we're gonna put some of these down. Alrighty. Now you don't wanna put these right by it because then you're gonna like, block off the sun. So, I'm gonna do that one. I'm gonna go down here and do that one there, and then we're gonna do that one there. I'm gonna go back the other way and do them the opposite way. Gonna do that one there. No, there. And basically, when these trees touch, when one kind of leaf touches another kind of leaf, that's where you start getting cross pollination. And then you start creating some really neat kinds of trees. So, them will grow eventually. Ooh, alrighty. So, we got a couple of things here. So, if we get out our handy dandy bee analyzer. So, let's see. So, we have a princess that is unusual and valiant. That was not supposed to happen. Supposed to make commons. So, one lesson here is stuff doesn't always work out how you think it's gonna work out. Just unusual meadows. So we don't have any more left. So, unusual and valiant and unusual and meadows. So what we're gonna do is put this guy back in there. And then we got a valiant drone. And we got a common. Yeah! We got a common, people. Alright, so... oh, there is something I probably need to do out here because currently there is no light. So let me plop down a couple torches. I can make this look neat. I was more worried about just creating the structure so I could get to the recording and doing this than the monsters that could potentially spawn. So if you look, you'll see that like it's nighttime. So these guys are not going to operate because it's nighttime. Right. Now if we look in here, remember we had a centrifuge going a while ago, boom, we got a little bit of honey drops. So we can put these in here and we get this guy, he's a common unusual. Common unusual right there. So we got common unusual, common meadows. So what I wanna do is put the commons and the commons unusual in here, and the hope is that the unusual trait becomes the dominant one. Alright, so it gets a common as a primary trait. I guess that's like the hope is that them traits sync up. Alright, so for this guy, we're just gonna drop him and him. Obviously one of them is meadows and one of them isn't. Ness, we got him, so we're gonna drop him in there and unusual. Now during the process you really don't need to watch as much. So we got a common drone. So we'll put him in there with the common drone. We'll watch as that little at-sea man comes at us. Then we do the common and... Alright, does this have common? That has a common trait. What about him? Nope. So we're going to put this guy in there because he has a common trait. And we're basically going to keep doing that. Now, got a whole bunch of crap bees here. Or do we? Because remember we put the drones in there? Well, this is a point to where I can take these kind of extra meadows drones I get. So unusual meadows, we'll put that guy in there. Now I normally wouldn't unusual meadows. Now I would rather put Burbred motor drones in there, but we don't have them. Alright, so we can get unusual meadows. And the hope is that even though meadows is a secondary attribute, it would become a primary one. I don't really care about these Valiants, and the reason is that the part, yeah, you see how they're not purebred? I don't care about them. I don't care about them, so we're gonna make these little guys, bam, and bam. Now, eventually that will be automated where we'll pull it out, we'll automatically throw them into the crate of DNA. But right now we don't need to worry about that. So, yeah, guys, that's pretty much the bees. This is something we're not really going to do a whole lot on camera. Instead, kind of once I get to a point that I've got something done, we'll come and check on it. So once I get to a point where I actually get the two bees I need to create aviaries done, then we'll come back and we'll check on it. And then after that, once I can actually make the aviaries, then we'll come back, and that's kind of how we'll run this. I do believe in the next episode, we're going to start on some magic crops. All right. So guys, I will see you then. Deuces.